सो फर्स्ट रिप्रेजेंटेशन ऑफ कर्व, व्हाट इज मीन बाय कर्व? सो द सिंपल डेफिनेशन ऑफ द कलेक्शन ऑफ पॉइंट, वी रिप्रेजेंट इट एज अ कर्व. अ कर्व व्हेन वी रिप्रेजेंट एज अ कलेक्शन ऑफ पॉइंट. बट वेदर इट इज अ सिंगल डेफिनेशन ऑफ कर्व, नो, इट इज नॉट अ सिंगल डेफिनेशन ऑफ द कर्व. देयर आर लॉट्स ऑफ डेफिनेशन फॉर द कर्व, बट वी आर गोइंग टू सी सम ऑफ द मेन डेफिनेशन रिलेटेड टू द कर्व. सो द फर्स्ट डेफिनेशन along with this, another definition is that when set of points, okay, I'm going to write it, when sets of points infinite or finite, any number of points, not necessary the point should be finite, any number of points infinite or finite are joined continuous, then it is called a curve. Then it is called a curve. Means, for example, suppose I draw here some points. These are infinite, and I join these points like this. It is a curve. Okay, any number of points, infinite or finite, when joined continuous, then we call it as a curve. Secondly, we can define it when we start from a point. Another definition, when start from a point, for drawing a geometrical figure, for drawing a geometrical figure and ends at some other, then without any gap, okay, join means start from, suppose this is point, this is another point, and I have drawn like this. Suppose this is point, I have drawn like this. So when we start from a point for drawing a geometrical figure and end at some other point without any gap, without any gap means, again, it is the word continuous. Without any gap, we call it as a curve. We call it as a curve. That is the simple definition of the curve. Now my one question, whether a line is a curve, suppose I draw a line like from here to here, so whether it is a curve? Yes, it is a curve. Why it is a curve? Because it start from a point, end with another point without any gap, and that's why line, mathematical term line, is also a curve. So if a line is curve, whatever the diagrams or the figures we draw, geometrical figures we draw with the line, all are curve. Means, suppose I draw this one, two lines connect, I draw a triangle, I draw a shape like this, then in this way, any kind of shape, I draw pentagon, then all these are curves. Without any gap, when we draw this, all are called curves. Why? Because the line is a curve, then all the figures, geometrical figures, which are drawn with the help of line, all are curves. So mathematically, all these figures are known as curves. So a curve is, generally speaking, an object similar to line but need not be straight. Again, see, a curve is similar to line but need not be same. sorry, need not be straight, any kind. So this is also a curve. So whether a circle is a curve? Yes, circle is also a curve. Circle is also a curve. But in computer graphics, in animation or all these things, we require some images like this. Suppose in this way I draw a image. Whether it is a curve? No, it is not a curve. Why? Because there is a gap in this. It is not continuous. There is a gap in this, and that's why it is not a curve. It is not a curve, but circle, we can say it is a curve, which is draw a continuous line, circular line without any gap. But this shape, this kind of shape is not a curve. These are some definition and the simple examples of curves. Again, we can say there are some simple types of curves. Now, the simple type of curves, there are many types, but simple type of curves we are going to see, that is open curve. Open curve, for example, suppose I draw like this. These are known as open curve. Closed curve. So these are closed curves, and crossing curves are also there. Such kind of diagrams are also required in computer graphics or in any other, this one. So these are also curves, but these are crossing curves, which are the lines are crossed to each other. So these are the simple type of curves: open curve, closed curve, and crossing curves. Now see, when we consider or draw a curve, as I told you that in the previous PPT, the number of infinite or finite number of points are connected to each other. Now how we connect this point? For example, suppose we consider here this example, okay, and here you can see these two points are connected with line in this way, and then it make a curve. So here, if we want a smooth curve, improve the representation of the curve, the simple way, increasing the point density. So here you can observe the point density is increased here. Point density is increased here. And so when these are connected with straight line also, the curve looks like a smooth one. In this, it is not a smooth one, correct? But here in this, it is a smooth one. Improve the representation of the curve. Why? Because we increase the point density in this curve or in these regions. So that is another point representation of the curve. Now, in computer graphics, we daily need to draw or design different types of objects which are not flat. Okay? Which are not flat means always drawing the curves or required the curves in this shape. In this shape, it is not sufficient in the computer graphics. Okay, we're not going to draw the flat surfaces or flat objects, but have we require the blends, derivations, and most importantly, smoothness in the computer graphics, as it is used for animation and all these purposes. So computers need to calculate or compute curves so that they can provide smoothness in the curve. Computers need to calculate or compute the curve which provide smoothness in the representation. And according to the computer graphics, the curve representation is divided mostly in two types. नॉन पैरामेट्रिक कर्व्स एंड पैरामेट्रिक कर्व्स. नॉन पैरामेट्रिक कर्व्स आर अगेन डिवाइडेड इनटू टू टाइप्स, एक्सप्लिसिट रिप्रेजेंटेशन एंड इम्प्लिसिट रिप्रेजेंटेशन. So here now we are going to see this explicit, implicit and parametric curve. Means we are going to study this non-parametric and parametric curve first. Simple types of curve representation according to the computer graphics. The first top sorry the first type of curve representation is the explicit representation of the curve. So in this simple, the explicit form of curve in two dimension, so x and y dimension is shown here in this diagram. X and y dimension, one variable, the value of one variable, we call that variable as a dependent variable. Suppose we call this is the dependent variable, y is the dependent variable. The value of one variable, the dependent variable, in terms of another variable, independent variable. Independent variable means here for every value of x, you can observe there is one value of y. For example, suppose this is 2, 2. So for value of x, there is a value of y. Here suppose it is 10, 10. The value of x, there is a value of y. So for every value of x, there is a value of y. So how we write the equation for this? Y is equal to fx. Y is equal to fx means we get the value of y from the value of x. It is possible, and that's why y is dependent variable and x we call it as the independent variable. So the simple example is the line example, line equation mx plus b. Means suppose I write here y is equal to 1/2 x plus 2. So many examples already we have seen previously. So y is equal to 1/2 x plus 2. So here if the value of x is equal to 10, 1/2 10 plus 2. 7. So what is the value of y? 7. So from the value of x, we can calculate the value of y. Means y is dependent on x. So many other examples we can write. Y is equal to, suppose I write 5x cube plus x square plus 2x plus 1, and in this way. Not a single way of writing the equation, but if such kind of equations are there which are in the two dimension, then one variable is dependent and another variable is independent, that we call as the explicit representation. Means the single value for each value of x, there is a single value of y. For each single value of x, there is a single value of y that we can calculate or compute. Now the implicit representation. Closed or multi-valued curves like the circle cannot be represented explicitly. So in that case, implicit representation is used. How we represent the equation of the circle? X square plus y square minus r square is equal to 0. That is the equation of circle. That is the equation of circle. So in standard, how it is written? F x y is equal to 0 means here both x and y values are important. Both are dependent on, means one is dependent, one is independent. In this way it is not there. So in this, dependent variable is not expressed in term of independent variable. So equation is written like this. To get the equation, both x and y values are required. For example, this equation of the circle, suppose I write here x square plus y square minus 1 is equal to 0. Both x and y are important. So we can convert the implicit function into the explicit. For example, this function, can we, then I say that it is the implicit. Can I convert into the explicit? By looking to that equation, it is possible. How? See here, x square, suppose I am. Y square is equal to 1 minus x square. So y is equal to 1 minus x square, the root of this. Correct? So in this way, we can represent y. From the x, we can calculate the value of y. But in computer graphics, we represent or we require the derivations. We require mathematical terms. Correct? So many mathematical terms and derivations are there. So it gives two kind of value. Positive value and also negative value. So while calculating derivation, whether to use this positive value or whether to use this negative value, that is the question. And for this, it creates the complications, and to avoid this implicit representation, we cannot convert into the explicit representation. Clear? So see, once again, here I am explaining that x square plus y square, this kind of function in two dimension is used to represent implicit curve. Now, the example, our circle example, we can write the equation like this. But can we convert this implicit form into the explicit form? It is possible, correct? So x plus y square minus 1 is equal to 0, then it becomes y is equal to plus minus root of 1 minus x square. Now this gives two values. One is the positive value and one is the negative value. In computer graphics, already you have seen in the previous all topics, so many mathematical calculations are there. Some derivations are there. So in that case, whether to consider positive or whether to consider negative, that is the question. And it becomes the complications or increase the complications. And that's why the new term implicit representation is separate and explicit representation is separate. So the general, then how the implicit form is representation? The implicit form is, in general, second degree implicit representation is done with this equation. How many coefficients are used here? 6 coefficients are used, A, B, C, D, E, F. So many types of curves and the so many type of diagrams are there in computer graphics. And that's why 6 different coefficients are used there. So this form of expression with the coefficients, 6 coefficients, provide a wide variety of 2D curve called the conic section. Provide a wide variety of 2D curve. We call it as the conic section. Now see, which kind of curves we can represent with this conic section or different types of with this 6 coefficient equation: parabolic, hyperbola, and ellipse. So that is shown with this simple diagrams: hyperbola, then parabola and ellipse. These type of conic sections we can represent with this equation. That equation, we can write it in the form of matrix also, because the when we use it in the form of matrix, it is easy for calculation, multiplication, and all these are things are possible with the matrix. So this same equation, if we write it in matrix form, it is like this: x, y, 1, a, b, b, c, d, e, f. And then x, y, 1 again. So when we perform this matrix multiplication, we will get this equation. So it is the reorganization of this equation in matrix form that we are going to use later on in the Bezier curve, B-spline curve. We are going to use this matrix representation. Okay, so if the conic, this equation, I am going to this equation write again. I will write it here. एक्स स्क्वायर प्लस बी एक्स वाई टू बी एक्स वाई प्लस सी वाई स्क्वायर प्लस टू डी एक्स प्लस टू ई वाई प्लस एफ इज इक्वल टू जीरो. ओके, सो हियर द एग्जाम्पल्स आर गिवन. हियर सम एग्जाम्पल्स हाउ दिस इक्वेशन इज यूज टू रिप्रेजेंट द डिफरेंट कोनिक सेक्शन. If the conic passes through the origin, then f is equal to 0. Means only these five coefficients are there, then it indicates that it passes through the origin. If b is equal to 0, if b is equal to 0 and c is equal to 1, then the curve is fixed by specifying four conditions, two end points and two slopes. Only two end points and the two slopes. For example, suppose I draw this curve. So this is the slope, this is the slope, this is one slope, this is another slope. We are going to see it in the cubic line and all these curves again in detail. Only remember that in this equation, if b is equal to 0 and c is equal to 1.0, then the curve is possible to fix with two endpoints and two direction or two slopes. If a is equal to 1, b is equal to 0 and c is equal to 1, then the equation becomes x square plus y square 2dx 2ey plus f is equal to 0. Then only three conditions are required here. You can observe d, e, f, two end points and either the slope at the beginning or the slope at the end. Either the slope at the beginning or at the end of the curve. If we use this equation or this condition, a is equal to 1, b is equal to 0, c is equal to 1, then any one of the slope is sufficient along with the two endpoints. Means only three coefficients are required here, d, e and f. A straight line is obtained using, suppose I want to draw a straight line using this equation. So a, b, c all are 0. A is 0, then this term will be not there. B is 0, C is 0. Then remaining term is dx plus cy plus f. And if we do it simplification, it becomes mx plus b. Y is equal to mx plus b. M is the slope of the line and b is y intercept. So if we want to represent a simple line, then for that a is equal to b is equal to c is equal to 0. So in this way, this single equation with six coefficients can be used to represent different kind of curves. And this equation again we are going to use in the next topics. So here these are the two types of curves, explicit and implicit, which are non-parametric. To explain, okay, so special conditions are there. If b square is equal to ac, if b square is equal to ac, the equation represent a parabola. If b square is less than ac, the equation represent ellipse. And if b square is greater than ac, then the equation represent hyperbola. So these are some special conditions with this equation.
We can represent the curve is the parametric curve. So first we are going to see why we use the parametric curve and in which cases we require the parametric curve. So as I told that there are so many types of curves. The curves may be open curve, coarse curve. So non-parametric curves are normally used to represent open curves, while parametric curves are suitable for representing closed curves and multivariate curves such as circles. Means for closed curves such as rectangle, circle, ellipse, in that case, normally the parametric curves are used. In parametric curves, each coordinate of a point on a curve is represented as a function of single parameter. So, for example, suppose these are the two points. This is the first point, we consider point P1 and this another point and we draw a curve from here, okay, in this way. So here this curve one point is considered as a position vector. Suppose this is the point we consider as a position vector. So the position vector of a point on the curve is fixed by the value of the parameter. As it is a 2D curve, it is represented with two dimensions. First is the x and second is the y coordinate. Now this point, which is we call as a position vector, on x, Cartesian coordinates of this point on x coordinate, how we represent? X is equal to xt and y is equal to yt. Okay, so it is in x direction and it is y direction, and this point P, how it is represented? It is represented as a position vector P, which has two values, x coordinate xc, coordinate it is yt. So in this way we represent the position vector of a point on the curve. Now see the next thing, that is tangent. The derivative of tangent vector on parametric curve, here the examples are given in the diagram. What is mean by tangent? You can observe here in this point where this curve and this straight line are touches to each other, it is tangent to the circle. In this curve, this straight line touches at this point, it is called as a tangent. And the tangent plane to a sphere, it is sphere, and this plane touches this sphere at this point, and that's why it is a tangent. This is the example what is mean by tangent. So in parametric curves, derivative or tangent vector on parametric curve is given by P dash T with two parameters. Again, in x direction it is x dash T, and in y coordinate it is y dash T, where this dash denotes differentiation with the respect to parameter. So in parameter, original parameter PT, how x and t, P T is to, in x direction it is xt and in y direction it is yt. Okay, so in this way, when we calculate the derivative of it, a tangent vector, it is denoted as P dash t is equal to x dash t and y dash t. Now for calculation of this tangent vector derivative, we require the slope of the curve. As there is a slope of the line, in this way there is also a slope of the curve. So what is the equation for slope of the line? The slope of the line M, how we represent? Delta y by delta x. So I write here M is equal to dy upon dx, delta y by delta x. And what is it? It is equal to y2 minus, if the line is from x1, x, y1 to x2, y2, then how we define the slope? Y2 minus y1 divided by x2 minus x1. In this way we define the slope of the line. So using the same, here we can define the slope of the curve. So slope of the curve dy upon dx is dy by dt divided by dx by dt, why there is a slope, and that we represent as y dash t divided by x dash t. So what is y dash? Y dash is dy by dt and x dash is dx by dt, that is derivative, which is represented by x dash and y dash t. And this is also known as a tangent vector for the parametric curve. Since a point on the parametric curve is specified by a single value of the parameter, the parametric form is axis dependent. It is represented with a single point. Okay, so this is the curve. Okay, in this we represent this single point. How we represent this single point? We represent this single point as a P T. And what is this PT? It is nothing but in x coordinate it is xt and in y coordinate it is yt. So in this way, we represent the point on any curve, a single value of the parameter. So the parametric form is axis dependent, x axis, y axis, axis dependent. So now this is an example we are going to see, that is parametric representation of a straight line. In parametric representation of a straight line, there are two points, correct? P1 and P2. Whenever a line is there, we consider there are two points, starting point P1 and end point P2. I write here P1 and this as P2. Okay. So when we represent this line, parametrically we represent this line, how we can represent it? For two position vectors P1 and P2, a parametric representation of line segment, okay, between them we represent as PT is equal to P1 plus P2 minus P1 multiply with where T is greater than or equal to 0 and less than or equal to 1. Now this point T that already we have seen, it is the point related to the position vector PT. So that PT, how we can represent on a line for two position vectors? P1 is the starting position vector and P2 is the end position vector. Then any point on the line, okay, parametric representation of any point on this line segment is P1 plus P2 minus P1 multiply with T. Now this is a point P1 which is represented as x and y coordinate, that is xt and yt. So in the term of xt and yt, how we can represent it? In this way. So xt is equal to x1, x2 minus x1 multiply with t. And yt is equal to y1, y2 minus y1 multiply with t. Now the example we will see. So once again, in this way we can represent a parametric representation of a straight line. Now here we consider a p1 and p2 two position vectors, p1 1, 2, x1, y1 and p2 3, that is x2, y2. So determine the parametric representation of the line segment between them. Okay. Here also we need to determine the slope or and the tangent vector of the line. So now see how to represent it. So already we have seen the previous slide. PT is equal to P1 plus P2 minus P1 multiply with T. Now put the values whatever given there in this equation. So what is point P1? It is 1 and 2. X1 is 1, Y1 is 2. Okay. Plus what are the points in P2? Next P2 minus P1. So P2 is 4, 3 minus P1, 1, 2. You put the values in the equation. Multiply with T. So here, PT, how we represent it? One, two, plus Okay, 4, 3 minus 1, 2. So it becomes 3, 1. 3, 1 multiply with the 3. Using the equation where t is greater than 0 and less than or equal to 1. So parametric representation, suppose we want to represent it in x, y point, okay? Parametric representation in x, y coordinates. Then using the values here, x1, y1 is given. So put that in the equation. How we calculate xt, the parameter at the x point. What is the equation for that? Same equation, x1 plus x2 minus x1 multiply with t. Now put this value in this equation. What is x1? In this case, 1 plus x2 minus x1. What is x2 minus x1? It is x2 is 4. 4 minus 1, 3 multiply with t. So, this is our equation for xt, x coordinate. Whatever the t value, it is ranges from 0 to 1. The point on that line is to be decided. Similarly, when we calculate it for yt, the equation for the y coordinate is y1 plus y2 minus y1 multiply with t. So, it is equal to, what is y1? 4, 2 plus 3 minus 2, 1 multiply with t. So, this is the 2 plus 1t. That is the equation for the y coordinate. The tangent vector from this we are going to calculate. What is the tangent vector? What is the equation for tangent vector? It is p dash t. It is p dash t is equal to x dash t and y dash t. Is equal to x dash t and y dash t. So from this above equation, what is x dash t and y dash t? Here we have calculated it is 3 comma 1, 3 and 1, correct? That we have calculated here using the equation. And here also you can see it is 3 and 1. So it is 3 and 1. So this is the tangent vector, that is the derivative and tangent vector for this one. We can represent in different ways as vi. So that I am going to show it again with the PPT. So that as per the equation, this we have calculated x and y components 1 plus 3t as xt and yt is equal to 2 plus t. The tangent vector is obtained by differentiating pt, that x dash t, y dash t, 3 and 1. Okay. So, in this way, we calculate the tangent vector. It is represented in different way also. Vi is equal to 3i plus j, where vi here the complement is used, is the tangent vector, and I and j are unit vectors in x and y direction. Instead of x and y here, I and j unit vectors are considered. So, that is about the tangent vector, how to calculate the tangent vector for the particular line. Now, the slope, how we calculate the slope? Dy upon dx, dy by dt divided by dx by dt. So, what is y dash t here? Y dash t is 1 here, correct? And what is x dash t? So, the slope of is by 3. So, for the line and the slope of the line we can calculate using this equation. So these two equations are required to calculate the tangent vector and slope of the line. That is parametric representation of a straight line. One example, line is also a curve that I told you in the previous lecture. That line is curve, your circle is a curve, rectangle, square, anything is a curve which does not have a gap. So the example here given about the parametric representation of straight line. Example. Now the next one, representation of space curve. That part we are going to see now. The 3D curves are represent, 2D curve we have seen, correct? The curve that already we have seen, these all are 2D curves, and that's why there are only two coordinates, x and y coordinate. Now we are going to see the 3D curves. So 3D space curves are represent non-parametrically and parametrically, as there are again two types to represent the space curve, non-parametric and parametric. Non-parametric, again there are two ways, explicit representation and implicit representation. Both are same as we have seen in the previous case, the example. In non-parametric, explicit, normally it represent with the equation y is equal to mx plus c. So that equation representation is explicit. One value, y value is either depend on x or x value is depend on y. Means taking the value of x, we can determine the value of y, or taking the value of y, we can determine the value of x. That is parametric explicit representation of the curve. But implicit representation, so all the things we cannot represent explicitly. In some cases we require the another, or we need to increase the polynomial of the polynomial degree of the equation. For example, we will represent the circle x square, okay, where instead of square I write here 2 minus r square, okay, is equal to 0. For the curve, it is in the polynomial degree, and that's why when we try to find out the equation for this, it is equal to becomes y is equal to square root of plus minus square root of that equation. It gives two values, either plus or minus. Now, when we represent it, which one to be considered? Either x to be considered, or sorry, either plus to be considered, or either minus to be considered. So, way it is not able to represent explicitly, that we call it as a implicit representation. So, here along with x and y coordinate, z coordinate is also used. So, you can observe here. It is z is used, and here also the z is used. So z that shown here with this. So by letting equal to t, we consider the z coordinate as a t. Then here the parametric equation for the curve normally represent as t raised to 3. Is to 2 t, in this way it is represent. We are going to see it in detail in the next slide. So remember that when we represent the parametric space curve in parametric form, then here two examples are shown here. One is the seam of baseball, curve on the seam of baseball is one example of 3D space curve, and helix, this is another example. So it is represent with the equations like this. We are not going to see this equation in details. That is only the example shown here of parametric space curve. Now in detail present this space curve that we are going to see here. There are mainly two types in which we can represent the space curves in 3D. Piecewise linear curve and second one is piecewise polynomial curve. So linear curve means it is represent with linear equation, as it is a name there, the linear curve. So straight line is some one of the linear curve, we can say. Why? Because it is represent with the equation y is equal to mx plus b. I'm going to draw here. For example, suppose there are some points. How the linear curve is represented? It is these two points are connected with a line. These two points are connected with another line. These two points are connected with a line. And these two points are connected with the line. So that is linear representation or piecewise linear curve. What we call it as a piecewise linear curve, which is represent with the linear equation y is equal to mx plus b. That is the first type of parametric space curve. How to represent? Okay. The second one is piecewise polynomial curve. So polynomial means it is represent with the degree of polynomial. So the equation example is given there, x3 plus x2 plus x square plus 8 or any number of degree is there. Now how we represent this curve? Normally the polynomial point. This way. So here these points are drawn here. The first point, second point, third point, fourth point, fifth point, sixth, seventh, and eighth. And these are connected instead of a straight line with the linear, these are represent as a curve. So these points are connected, then these points are connected in this way. These points are connected with each other. So why then it is known as a polynomial representation, piecewise polynomial representation of the curve. Now how we decide this degree x raised to 3? If there are 4 points used to draw a curve, then its degree is x raised to 3. If there are 4 points are used to draw a curve, then its degree is x raised to 3. Now in our example, how many points are there? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. So here how we represent is x raised to 6. How we represent is x raised to 6 plus x raised to 5 plus x raised to 4. In this way it is represent. Now suppose we consider there is a line of 16 points. I'm going to draw this line with the curve. Draw a curve with 16 points. And then I draw a curve here. Okay, so in this way we will draw a curve with the 16 points. Now, what is the polynomial of this equation? It is x raised to 15. As there are 16 points, it is x raised to 15. Now, for this curve, there is a polynomial of x raised to 15. So, when it is x raised to 15, it is very complex for execution and representation. And that's why we are going to consider the point with polynomial is x raised to 3. We are going to represent with polynomial, or we are going to curve of 4 points with polynomial of degree 3 only, x raised to 3, because representing or execution of the more degree is very complex. Okay. So now to represent it with the equation form, we write there are three coordinates x, y and z. Why? Because it is the 3D curve as a space curve. So x is equal to xt. Y is equal to yt and z is equal to zt. And the point Q is represented like this. Suppose there is a curve, I am going to draw it here, 4-point curve. 1, 2, 3 and 4. Okay, we call it as a point number A, point number B, point C, and this is point D. So D point, D 4 points are there, and for that we are going to draw or represent it with the equation. So it is like this, Q of T is equal to X of T with three coordinates now instead of two, here the three coordinates, xt, yt and zt. So general form of equation, how we write here for xt, I am going to write here. As there are 4 points A, B, C, D, and there are 4 points means it is a degree 3. So start with first point is A with respect to x. So actually it is subscript with respect to x, t raised to cube. Okay. T raised to cube. Then plus B with respect to x, point B with respect to x, t, and then superscript 2 means square. Not possible to write here. It is. So raised to 2 B x t square. Then third with respect to C, X, T and the last one is D. So in this way, DX, in this way we represent the X coordinate for this 3D space. Why there are 4 points A, B, C, D. So A, X, T raised to 3 plus B, X, T square plus C x t plus d x. So if there are 5 points, now we can represent it with the 5 points. If there are 6 points, if there are only 3 points, how we represent? A x t square plus b x t plus c x. So that is the equation we write for x t. So in the same way, the remaining are the equations for already x t raised to cube plus dx t raised plus t plus dx. In the same way, y related a y t raised cube a y t square a y t dy, and in the case of z t. Now all this together is the point q t on that particular the position vector, as we have seen 2D the position vector for 3D, where present matrix form that we afterwards during the calculation. So t is equal to how we represent t cube t square t and 1. For d there is no value multiply with t, so it is t cube t square t and 1, that is our t, capital T. And the c is the value we represent ax, ay, az, bx, by, bz, cx, ty, cz and dx, dy, dz. And when we multiply this, we will get this equations x t, y t and z t. Means these three equations we can represent it in matrix form. So in this way parametric cubic curve are represented. And that is the representation of space curve.